bother to get a score on that one. All right, our next guest is one of the great rock musicians in the history of this country. His new CD is called Freedom's Road. We like him so much, we invited him to stay for tonight. For the first of two, please say hello to John Mellencamp. Thank you for being here. It's great to have you here. I saw you're chewing gum and smoking at the same time. That's impressive. You're a very talented guy. I saw you at the...
We'll sell out on eBay afterwards.
I saw you last year at the Hollywood Bowl, and it really was a great show, a fantastic show. You still love going on the road and doing that touring?
I bet I've done 150 million shows. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I like it. The first, 30, 40 shows is great because the audience is there. And then after a while, it kind of turns into a grind. But I paced myself over the last 30 years. And So
if someone were to come see you at the end of your tour, they should know you're going through the motions.
No. Now, I figure if somebody's paying $75 to come and see me, I was playing in Atlanta a couple of summers ago when it was real hot. You guys remember that summer, real hot. And I walked down on stage, it was 105 degrees. And before the show, I was thinking, I'm just going to walk through this. It's 105 degrees. It's 9 o'clock at night. And John Fogerty was opening up for me. And it was... I thought, I could see John on the monitor. And he's killing himself, and I'm thinking, oh, man. Now, I got to go out and, John's giving 200%, and I got to go out and give 200%.
Well, did you have a talk with him and tell him not to do that again?
I did. I said, thanks, John.
I found out that I didn't realize this, because you're known to be a great songwriter, that your first two albums were cover albums.
That's not really true. I went to New York when I was like 21 years old, and I was either going to be a painter or I was going to try to get a record deal, and I didn't have the money to get in New York Art Student League, so the record deal happened real quickly, and I had only written about 3 or 4 songs. Man, I was a singer in a band, mm-hmm. all through high school, and we sang James Brown songs, and I was in a soul band, and the idea of having to write songs, I thought, James already wrote a bunch of good ones. Why writing songs?
He's his.
Yeah. Been singing his for the last 10 years. But, it was great. And in 1966, being 14 years old, and I can't believe my parents let me do it, actually. I'd get in the car with like a bunch of 20-year-old guys, and we'd go play bars and fraternities, and made $36 a night. Come on. I was the best-dressed kid in high school.
I bet, yeah. This is one of your paintings, and
wait a minute.
Hold on.
That's a card of one of my paintings.
All right, this is a card.
That painting is like 16 foot long and like maybe 8 foot high.
Wow.
And you're holding up a 6x12 card.
Yeah. Well, we couldn't get the whole house on the plane. This is tell us about this painting.
That is a painting that was done in the. That's a really old painting, and that is Elaine and myself the first day we met.
Wow.
She's sitting right there.
She looks really happy to meet you. Elaine is a delightful, delightful woman. Elaine, is this what sealed the deal, the painting? Had you known, well, what more could you have done? You married the man, for God's sake. This is... This has an interesting story, I understand.
This is a record company executive.
Which one?
Yeah. Well, with his new wife, they're divorced now, and I gave, that's a huge painting also, that's like 10 foot high, and you know, it was, it got burnt up. But I gave it to him, and this singer, this gal here, I kinda, she didn't like the way I painted her, because if you can see, her hips are a little hippie, and she was pretty unhappy about it, so the painting never got hung up anywhere, and they put it in storage, and the storage place burnt down, because I said, man, if you're not going to put the painting up, give it back to me, and
she didn't go along with that?
Well, I think she burned it up.
All right, well, you know what, I'm running out of time, but I know you brought the guitar here, so I don't want to, would you mind? Now, this song, you get a little bit of, I wouldn't say, no, criticism or whatever, over the song Our Country that you wrote, because it became a commercial, Chevrolet commercial.
I still don't think people should sell their songs for commercials, but, when you want to get your songs heard in today's marketplace, radio's different, television's different, it's easy to be noble when you're on MTV every 2 seconds and the radio's playing your songs now, but if at my age, the middle-aged guys, old guys. Jim said, ideas I think are right, and I can stem said, the idea to stand and fight. I do believe there's a dream for everyone. This is our country. That's the part they liked. From the East Coast to the West Coast, down the Dixie Highway, back home. This is our country, and there's room enough here for science to live, and there's room enough here for religion to forgive, and try to understand all the people of this land. This is our country. Anyway.
Yeah. From the new CD when we come back.
Well, I want to tell you, I wrote this song. I was watching television. They were interviewing our president. It was right when the Dixie Chicks got in all that trouble. And they asked him, they asked Bush, they said, well, what do you think about the unfair treatment that the Dixie Chicks have been getting? And he says, well, that's the price of freedom. Sometimes you have to pay a harsh price for the words that come out of your mouth. And that's why it goes, from the East Coast to the West Coast, down the Dixie Highway, back home.
Oh, there you go. That's interesting. We'll hear more from John Mellencamp. Andy Garcia is with us, too. His new CD is called Freedom's Road. We'll be right back. John Mellencamp. Bye-bye. We're
back. Andy Garcia is with us with the song Freedom's Road from the new album of the same name, Freedom's Road, John Mellencamp.
I'm navigating my way down Freedom's Road, trying to make my way back home. I got my foot to the floor, but she must need a bleeding. This car just don't want to roll. Freedom's Road must be under construction. Sometimes you wonder what kind of freedom they're talking. If you're here looking for the devil, you'll find him on Freedom's Road. Sometimes there's rape, sometimes there'll be murder, sometimes just darkness everywhere. No passing signs and those barbed wire fences, misinformation, but no one cares. Freedom's Road. can get narrow, but no one wants to know you if there's no pork in your barrel. If you're here looking for the devil, well, he's out there on Freedom's Road. Freedom's Road, Freedom's Road. If you want to take a ride, well, you got to pay the toll. Freedom's Road, Freedom's Road. If you're looking for the devil, well, he's out there on Freedom's Road. You can drop your bombs and you can beat the people senseless, but that won't get you anywhere. Hide your agendas behind public consensus and say, hey, this world just ain't fair. But Freedom's Road is a promise to the people. You won't fool us now with all your lying and cheating. So if you think they're gonna give you a crown in heaven, get out there on Freedom's Road. Freedom's Road, Freedom's Road. If you wanna take a ride, well, you got to pay the toll. Freedom's Road, Freedom's Road. If you're looking for the devil, well, he's out there on Freedom's Road. No escalation.